$59, huh?
What are you doing, Pa?
Quiet. Your father's auditing my account. I may be arrested for embezzlement.
Expenses, food, rent, clothes, insurance, entertainment, medical expenses, light, gas, and water is 17. 36 divided by 2. Multiply. Carry 6. Add 12.
All right, Mastermind, what did you find?
According to my figures, the family starved to death 3 months ago.
All right, after this, don't tell me I don't know how to manage.
Peg, we got to increase our income.
But how?
I don't know, but I'll figure out something. Junior, how much allowance am I paying you each week?
Oh, jeepers, Pop, don't cut my allowance. I only get 50 cents.
Don't worry, I'm not cutting it. It stays the same.
Oh, swell.
Except from now on, I'm charging you $1 a week, room and board.
What?
Oh, no, Pop, that's not fair. Besides, I only get 50 cents.
All right, then I'll raise your allowance to $1. I'm going to balance these books or go broke doing it.
Oh, that's ridiculous. You can't treat your children like boarders.
Well, he eats like a boarder, don't he?
Oh,
but... Oh, forget it.
I can solve the whole problem.
Gillis, will you butt out of this? I'll see you later. I got problems.
I can solve the whole thing. You should take in the border.
Huh? Now, Riley, we'll discuss this later.
Hey, that's a great idea. We got the room. That was a smart move of mine to close in that back porch.
Now, Riley, wait.
Yeah, you can get at least 10 bucks a week. For a closed-in porch? No, for your room. And you move into the porch. Huh?
Please, Mr. Gillis.
Oh, no. I'm not going to move out of my room and sleep on a cot in the porch.
Junior, during an emergency, the family has to make sacrifices.
Well, why pick on me? What's wrong with your room?
There's a nice thing. He wants you to sleep out in the porch and me sleep in our room with a stranger.
Will you all be quiet and listen to me? There'll be no more talk about borders.
Yeah, I tried to help you, Riley, but I'm through. I ain't the type who butts in.
It's all set, Peg. We're taking in a border. That's final. My head is made up.
Oh. Oh, hi, Mr. Gillis.
Hiya, Babs.
Babs, we're getting a border.
Don't you butt in.
Oh. A border?
That's right.
You mean rent out a room?
That's right.
So don't argue, because I hate family arguments. That's why I came over here tonight.
Oh, no. This house is crowded enough as it is. With 4 people and only 1 bathroom. Now you want another person.
Just a minute, Miss Riley. Just because you go to high school, don't get so fancy.
Yeah, she ought to consider herself lucky. At least she's got a bathroom.
Why, I can remember when I... My kid... When I was your age, all we had in the house was a double laundry tub in the kitchen. Saturday nights, I had to soap up in one and rinse off in the other.
Your forefather needed the money.
Oh, but a boarder would just...
A boarder would just disrupt this entire household.
A boarder will disrupt nothing.
He won't even know he's here.
Yeah. All you gotta do is fix his meals, make his bed, clean his room, empty his ashtrays, send out his laundry and take his phone messages. No trouble at all.
It's just like having another husband around.
Yeah.
I still say you shouldn't have rented that room without consulting me first.
I tell you, this fella's all right. I wouldn't okay a boarder unless he was okay from A to Z.
What's he like?
Well, he's swell. Now, what time is it?
Almost 9. What's he like?
Well, Now, when he gets here, I want everybody to be very nice to him. First impressions are very important. After we get him hooked, then we can go back to being ourselves.
Renting a room to a perfect stranger.
He's not a stranger. I know all about him. He's a very high-type man.
All right. What kind of work does he do?
Well, he has one of those... Well, I don't know yet, but he's a very high-type man.
How old is he?
Oh, I'd say he was in the neighborhood of... Well, he's... Well, I don't know exactly, but he's a very high-type man.
What's his name?
His name is, Oh, what is that? It's a long... Well, I don't know his name, but he's a very high...
I don't know his name. What does he look like?
Oh, well, he stands... Will you stop asking silly questions?
I just want to know what he looks like.
Well, how should I know? I haven't met him yet.
What? You rented a room to a man you never even saw?
You don't know his name, you don't know what he does, you don't know anything about him.
Peg, I tell you, he's a very respectable man. He comes to me with the highest recommendation from my friend Jim Gillis. And what's good enough for Gillis is good enough for me. Now are you satisfied?
Well, why didn't Gillis tell you what he does, then?
Because he hasn't met him yet, either.
Gillis doesn't know him either. Oh.
Well, he heard about him from Joe at the pool room's cousin's.
Look, we need a new washer for the sink. So you have six different plumbers up here to show you samples. But you'll pick up a boarder right off the street.
I guarantee you this is a nice fella. He'll be no more trouble than I am.
Los Angeles police have been warned to be on the lookout for Bullets Durgum, convicted burglar, who last week shot two Bakersfield police and escaped in a stolen car.
What are you reading that stuff for?
Tall, heavy-set, cold-blooded killer, Durgum is known to be hiding out in or around Los Angeles. He has a $10,000 reward on his head.
Will you keep quiet? You're going to have your mother and sister all nervous. I tell you, this man is a...
You don't know a thing about it.
Charlie, I beg you not to do this.
Will you stop imagining things? He's a swell guy. You and your crime stories. Just remember, I'm here to protect you. You let him in, Peg.
And don't you dare rent that room until you find out more about him.
Leave it to me. I'll know all there is to know about him. I'll pump him dry. We've been expecting you, Mr.
Ferguson.
Oh, Ferguson. Nice name.
Okay if I come in?
Yeah, sure. Come right in. Just having a game of ball. Your side wins, Peg. I want you to meet my family. This is Peg, my wife.
Hello.
This is Babs, my daughter, and this is my boy, Junior.
Evening.
Well, let's all sit down and get acquainted.
Yeah, mind showing me to my room? I'm kind of tired.
Oh. Well, I guess you have to get up pretty early in your line of work. My line of work happens to be riveting. That's a lot different from your line of work. Originally, I come from Brooklyn. Brooklyn, New York. That's in the USA. I guess different people come from different places. My line of work happens to be written.
Mind showing me to my room? I'm kind of tired.
Yes, sir. It's the last room down at the end of the hall. Could I help you with your bag?
No, thanks. I can manage. Good night.
Good night. Nice, quiet fella.
You certainly pumped him dry.
He could be the guy, all right. Will you stop with that convict stuff? I know an honest man when I see one. Besides, his name ain't,
Bullet Durgum.
Oh, he could be using an alias.
I don't like his looks.
I tell you, he's all right. I know characters.
Oh, Mr. Riley.
Mr. Riley.
Oh, yes, Mr. Ferguson.
Mind if I use your phone?
No, go right ahead. Here, can I dial the number for you?
No, thanks, I can do it.
Oh.
Hello, Mac. It's me. Yeah. Anything new? No kidding. Front page, huh? Yeah, I'll keep my eyes open. Say, if you want to get in touch with me, I'm at Arizona 1313. Yeah. Okay. Be seeing you. Good night.
Good night.
He's talking to his mom.
Mark down that number. Arizona 1313.
That's our number.
Junior's right. He's a gangster.
Now, don't jump at conclusions.
I'm scared to death, I tell you. I won't be able to sleep in this house tonight.
You'll be able to sleep. Take a pill.
worried. You got to do something.
Hiya, folks. Gillis.
He's here. He's here.
Who's here?
The new boarder.
Well, great. Now your money troubles is over. Thanks to me.
Yeah, but he's a kind of funny guy.
Suspicious looking.
Where is he? I'll give him the once-over.
He won't tell you nothing.
All we know is his name is Ferguson.
Oh, it's his alias.
Yeah, you know, a pseudonym.
A pseudonym?
What for?
Because the cops are after him.
The cops?
Will you stop imagining things?
He's a killer.
A cold-blooded killer.
Will you shut up? He's going to hear you.
You took a killer in for a boarder? You're money crazy.
We can't be sure that he's a criminal, only he acts very mysterious. He won't talk.
Well, maybe he's shy. Lots of people are shy. I myself, me, very shy. Believe me, you're imagining things.
He talked on the phone. It sounded like to his gang.
Yeah, I don't like his looks.
His looks?
A tall, heavy set, cold-blooded killer.
That's the spitting image of him. This is all your fault, you and your boarders.
Well, don't blame me. Throw him out if you're so particular the type boarder you want.
I should throw him out.
You scared, Pop?
Me scared.
You recommended him?
You throw him out.
You're scared.
Oh, I'd throw him out in a minute if I was in the mood. But I got no proof he's a wrong guy, and neither of you.
But
no.
The paper.
Yeah, how about the paper? Papers, or they print baloney. Did the guy admit he's the one?
No, but...
No, we can't be sure, only...
Yeah, but, you know, you can sometimes lose a nice, hard-working boarder, kind of an idle rumor. Now, calm down and relax.
Oh, Mr. Riley.
I'm... Hey,
Riley.
Yeah, Mr. Ferguson.
Mind if I see your paper?
No, I'll go right out and get you one.
Now, that one'll do.
Here you are.
Thanks.
This is my friend, Mr. Gillis. How do...
Here it is. Mind if I tear apart?
No, tear it off.
Yeah. Okay to take a bath?
Oh, sure. Help yourself.
Thanks. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
In my opinion, you better throw the guy out. It'll take a lot of guts, but it's got to be done.
He's right. He's got to be thrown out.
Peg, throw him out.
Me? Oh, no. Call the police.
Tell him to bring machine guns.
Watch yourself. In case this guy is okay, he can sue you for false arrest.
Sue me?
Certainly. You got to be sure, Feist.
Riley, you got to find out more about that man.
But he won't tell me anything.
Well, after all, he's paying $10 a week. He's entitled to some privacy. You ain't got no right prying into the man's private life. Besides, there's a more polite way.
What?
Search his baggage.
Huh?
Now, while he's in the bathtub. That's it. Maybe I'll find a clue. Okay. Everybody stay here.
Be careful.
O'Reilly always protects his family. You come with me. You're the lookout.
Who, me?
Stay in a hole and yell if he stops bathing.
Yeah. Gee, I hope he's good and dirty.
Locked.
Oh.
This is open. Let's see now. Shirts. Socks. Tie. Gun, jacket, bullets,
and pajamas.
Hurry up, he's coming. Put the stuff back.
Pajamas, bullets, gun, blackjack, ties,
sugar. Oh, I was so worried if he had caught you.
There's nothing to worry about. I feel a little better now since I went through his bags.
Did you find anything?
Nah, he's got a lot of junk.
He wears cotton socks.
Now we can all stop worrying and go to sleep.
Oh, sleep with a perfectly strange man in the house.
There's nothing to be scared about. I'm here to protect you. He makes one false move and I'll take his gun and his blackjack and I'll...
Oh, black...
He's got a gun
and a blackjack.
Yeah. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Quick, out of the house.
Call the police. Not from here. He'll hear you.
All right, I'll use your phone.
Not the door. He's got a mob. Don't want to get even. I ain't getting involved in this.
Gee, Pop, you're going to get $10,000 reward.
Reward? Yeah, reward.
What?
It's
seeing you, my pal. You can use my phone and we'll split the reward 50-50.
Will you hurry?
What do you mean, split the reward 50-50? I get the whole reward. Oh, yeah? You ain't gonna cheat me out of my half.
Your half? He's my boarder, ain't he?
Let's go through the house. Come on. Did you say his room is?
It's the last room down the hall. $10 a week.
We're going in.
We are?
Not sure. You stay here.
Oh, if you insist. Watch out now. He's a cold-blooded killer.
You mean he was a killer? Come on, Steve. Come on, Bobby. Answer the phone. If it's for him, find out who's calling.
Yes, sir, but I ain't giving my right name.
Hello? Who?
Oh. It's the Gottlieb Survey. They want to know what radio program we're listening to.
Hang up.
Hang up.
Felix, instead of going in, let's stay out here. We got a better chance of taking him alive.
Yeah.
You wait till we get set, then call him in here. Tell him he's wanted on the phone. Then beat it.
Came to trap a killer.
Killer?
Yeah.
You.
I thought. My family thought. My wife thought. The gun, blackjack, your cotton socks.
What are you so nervous about, Riley?
Who's nervous?
That's the type, citizen, we're sworn to protect.
Hi, Riley. Hello, Daddy.
Hiya, Pa.
You're home early, dear.
Well, I had a little headache, so I thought I'd get off early.
Oh, you poor darling.
Maybe you hit your head when you fainted.
I did not faint. I got a little tired from capturing the cops, so I laid down. On the floor? Now, look, don't you start in. I've been getting it all day at the plant. Gillis told all the guys.
Oh, that Gillis.
Peg, that Ferguson has got to go.
Why? He's a perfect boarder.
Yeah, but a cop hanging around the house watching every move I make.
Oh, Riley.
Good afternoon.
Hello, Mr. Ferguson.
Hi.
What would you like for supper, Mr. Ferguson?
Oh, I won't be here for supper.
Oh, what a shame.
Now, it's his duty. You know what they say about policemen. Neither hail nor snow nor sleet can stop these couriers.
That's the postman.
Oh. Yeah, that's the postman. The policeman saying goes, hail to the flat-footed minions of the law.
I think the word is fleet-footed.
Yeah, fleet-footed.
Well, I have to be going. Is there a phone booth in the neighborhood?
Yes, there's one down at the corner, but why don't you use this phone?
No, thanks. These are toll calls.
Hey, Ferguson, I know how you can beat the telephone company. You know when you make a long-distance call, you put a nickel in and the operator says, deposit 15 more cents, please. Don't do it. Instead, you make a fist and give it three terrific bangs. And in that way, you cheat the company out of a smart 15 cents.
You know you can go to jail for that?
Yeah. And if I ever catch anyone doing it, officer, I'll turn them right over to you. You'll find that I'm going to be the best landlord and stool pigeon you ever had.
Oh, got my...
Wise guy. He's got no business prying into my private life. Just because he pays $10 a week rent. Hey, has he paid you the rent yet?
Why, no.
Well, he's supposed to pay in advance, ain't he?
That's the usual thing.
He's got some nerve stalling on a rent.
You better not get tough with him, Pop.
Oh, no? Thinks just because he's a cop, he can get away with it, huh? Thinks he scares me or something.
Don't make such a fuss, dear. He hasn't even been asked for it.
Well, he will be asked. I'm gonna ask him. He cheated me out of that reward, but he ain't cheating me out of the rent.
Hey, you just ask him.
Don't worry, I'll ask him. And if he don't cough it up, out he goes. You better keep that door open, Junior. I might have to throw him out.
Come in.
Hello, Mr. Ferguson. I was wondering, well, not that I care, but, well, it's usual. You see, I don't care when you pay, but my wife, well, you know how women are, crazy for a buck, and,
You're talking about the rent, Riley?
Yeah, I know you're good for it, of course.
It's all right, I meant to give it to you before. Yeah. Five, ten.
Thank you very much.
Say, I just happened to be selling some tickets to the policeman's ball.
Policeman's ball?
Yeah, only $1 a piece.
$1.
That's fun.
Well, I'll take two.
Ten.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, did you get the rent?
Yeah, I got it.
Well, hand it over. That ten will come in handy. I got to pay the butcher.
Here. I hope the butcher likes dancing.
The policeman's ball.